Well, Operation Push is a nonviolent protest to get what we deserve from our government. They use wordplay and deceive the public about what really goes on inside the system, and we want to expose those things as well as make changes that will benefit us as inmates and also society at large. There are various industries that are run by inmates, and we intend to sit down and refuse to work, have an economic protest, if you would, to try to bring about change. We want to open up dialogue with the governing parties that oversee the prison system. We want to bring parole. By bringing parole back, it would force inmates to have certification from anger management to Narcotics Anonymous. They got to get GEDs. They got to stay out of trouble for a certain period of time just to meet the criteria to be eligible for parole. So it would cut down the violence that takes place in prison, and it would also, you know, ensure that every person is equipped with what they need to re-enter into society. We want to be paid for the work that we do as well, so that somebody doesn't end up doing 10, 15, 20 years not being paid and sent home with a bus ticket and a $50 check. We want to create an environment where someone can do their time, be rehabilitated, and enter into society with some type of hope and not hopelessness. I joined this action because I have been subject to the system, and I see all the flaws, and I see our people being destroyed, you know, from a lack of knowledge, from a lack of opportunity. So I want to organize for change so that I can, you know, help to do whatever I can to create a system that is being described to the public, a system that protects the public and the best interests of the public. If I were living in a neighborhood and someone were coming home from a situation like this after spending 10, 15, 20 years in the system, I'd rather that person come home educated with a couple of dollars in their pocket, so they're not relying on the skill that whatever skill set they had that landed them in prison. And they just didn't do all that time not being treated mentally with a program that one would have to complete to be eligible for parole. But I'd rather someone come home like that than someone come home that sat for 15, 20 years under oppression with no money and no skills, no training. And I think that would be helpful for society, instead of creating a revolving door where you lock people up and just set them up for failure so that they keep on coming back. The voice on the outside has to be loud. We need to shine a light from the outside in on this system. For us, trying to yell between the gaps in the fence, the people on the outside, is not going to be beneficial, because then we'll be taken advantage of by these officials. But if there's enough light shining on the situation, then they won't be able to do certain things and get away with them. They can lock us down in CM, which is control management. They can put us in the box. They can take away privileges, is what they describe them as, when it comes to using the phone and letters and stuff like that. They have little blind spots in the law where they can do certain things that can strip you of those rights. So you cannot communicate with your family members. They'll lose you in the system, and they have the right to keep it confidential where you are and all that type of stuff. So your family won't know where you are. They won't know what type of health condition you're in. And it's just, it can just be a very bad situation for us without that support on the outside. But when we have rallies outside the prison, when we have media support, when it's being mentioned on the radio, on mainstream programs, then it creates an environment. It keeps them honest, because now the eye is on them, public eye. But that's what we need very heavily, is that media support on the outside. Any way that this situation can gain exposure is what we need in the Panhandle area and all across Florida, because this this movement is not just for the Panhandlers, but it's for all the correctional facilities in Florida. You know, violence never brings about the desired results, so we're taking a different approach. And the approach that we're employing is one that has been done before and has been proven. In 1967, Martin Luther King led a protest, a boycott against the bus system for equal rights. The signs that were instructing black people to sit at the back of the bus, what they did was they boycotted the buses for 318 days, and it brought about change. He also led a similar boycott for Christmas, and they were very successful. So that's why we're taking that strategic approach, because we don't want to put ourselves in a position where officers are required to use brute force and given an excuse to give to the public why they used it. We want to put this out there and make and emphasize that it's a non-violent protest that if we can even do without talking, we'll do without talking until the proper official comes that can bring about change, so that we can list our demands and that we can come to the table to compromise to see how well we can find some middle ground to meet. But it has been done in history. It's an economical strike, and we just intend to affect the budget as much as we can next year. The budget that the public is being told is supported by tax dollars, which is fabricated, which is a lie. The system actually pays for itself. I have done research that tells me that there are 3 million prisoners in the DOC system across the United States, and the industries that we run are laundry and agriculture and cooking, kitchen, maintenance, everything. This whole entire operation is run by inmates on the inside. We do the upkeep, we do the maintenance, we do the painting. So by sitting down and refusing to work, these officials will have to find some replacement in doing those jobs. By law, they have to feed us, so they're going to have to find people to cook and serve the food. And every day that we sit down will affect the budget for next year. So we're hoping to bring about enough effect to where, you know, we're taking seriously. But that's why the voice in the street is so important, because inmates are ready to rally behind that voice in the streets. But as it is right now, it's a very tentative situation, because if we don't feel that confident, it's going to bring about division. So the most important thing is that exposure that we've been talking about this entire conversation. We need exposure in the Central Florida, South Florida, Panhandle, East and West Florida. Well, you know, there are many different groups that make up the prison system. There are gangs, there are people from different ethnicities, there are religious groups. In the beginning, it was a movement that was coming together very well, but over the course of time, the officers here have become aware. They know that it's coming. So now the inmate population feels like they have the upper hand. So we're really looking for our outside support to do the things that we're telling them are needed, like get us exposure, get us on the radio, get us on TV, put groups together to protest out in front of the facilities, and that will bring us all back together again. And thank everyone that did in support. God bless you all.